So, yeah, I see this. I'm a street performer for 25 years. I worked at a theme park, a dying theme park, in the south of Japan, house in Boston, through the winter. I performed for crowds in weather, kind of similar to this sometimes, of like 1 to 2 people. And what you do is you keep your chin up, keep it personal, and yet, while you're keeping it personal, you get to know people's names, you kind of have a mentality that you're speaking to just dozens and dozens of people, you know. Because I'm a street performer, we don't perform for that many. But one of the things all street performers know is that a dense crowd is a good crowd. That means a crowd that's tightly packed in. And here in Eugene, usually the crowds are very dense. Especially since the year when it got legalized. But tonight, you know, our crowd isn't huge because of the weather. And I was talking to in our little practice last night, I was saying we should put out fewer chairs in the outs, in the background, in the back, so that people stay more up close, and then we'll have a denser crowd. Now, the other thing I think was a big mistake was putting the cold-looking chairs up front. Because these chairs, even though they're warm, they're room temperature, they've been in here all day. They look cold. They look really cold. Anyway, here's the barrier that people usually have to moving forward. Does everybody know what it is? You might want to leave. When you move forward, you're committing to a show that might suck. And there you are, stuck in the front row. The beautiful thing about no shame is it's done up in little 5-minute chunks. Every 5 minutes, you have a chance to duck out. You can duck out for however many minutes you want and then come back, or you can duck out forever. That's the freedom of no shame. So, were you guys to, for instance, as Tamathy's gonna do, pick up that metal chair and move it out of the way? Any other no-shamers want to move some of those metal chairs out of the way? Perhaps you might want to help. Mike, you might want to help. That's cool. And then if any of you in the back, with your cushy chairs, in fact, you guys could just move some cushy chairs, and maybe some people will move forward, and we can make a dense crowd. It's better. By the way, just so you guys know, the classic mistake junior street performers make when they form their first edge is they don't bring them forward. It is practically impossible to do a good show to a distant crowd. It just doesn't work. You bring them up forward, and all of a sudden, you have this rapport. They gotta smell your pits. Or they're not gonna feel you. And as street performers, you think that would be easy, but actually, when it's windy out there, it can just be one side. All right, I have one more minute. Now, here's the other thing. Don't move up by yourself. That will be embarrassing. Because you'll feel singled out. Some of you way in the back. Yes. Yes. Like, what's your name again? You have the same name as Elvis's former wife.
No, daughter.
Daughter. Lisa Marie, you stay back there. You are not part of the group. An outsider, we don't want you. No! Guys! No! I always said, I'm trying to build a rapport here. You can't have an in-group without an out-group. It's okay. She's white, she's Anglo-Saxon. She's very pretty. She can take it. So anyway, now, looks like people already moved. Anyway, I'll try. We'll see if anybody moves. On the count of three, when I say three, everybody scoot forward a little bit. Even if you don't move, scoot forward. 1, 2, 3, scoot forward. Go scoot, get up and move forward, move forward. See, they're doing it. I have confidence in my voice. Now, as a reward, there's one last thing I'm gonna say. You're gonna love this joke. How many things does it take to make a thing?